AHL Road Trip, March 7th, 8th, 9th, 2014, Upper State, New York. Theme, Schultzy. You got nothing to worry about.
How is it, Dooley? Relax, Schultz. You got nothing to worry about.
Okay, day one of the road trip, March 7th. We leave Doug's house, Mansfield. The four of us jump in the car and head up to Utica for hopefully a good day. We get up to Utica sometime in the early afternoon, and we found a nice place to have lunch. The Celtic Hop, would highly recommend it to anybody that's heading up in Utica. After lunch, we had a couple of beers there and waited until the tour at 3 o'clock over at the Saranac FX Matt Brewing Company. The tour was very interesting, a lot of historical information provided. We even saw a 5-gallon beer stein, which Keith was ready to steal and throw in the back of the car, but we held off. Keith and I got lost during the tour. We wound up behind some mash tun, but eventually they found us in time for the drinking afterwards. And the four of us must have looked good to some of the younger folks there because they gave us a whole bunch of tickets for free beers, so needless to say, we put most of them to good use.
Yeah, we got a portable camera you got there, huh?
Get the video of the Anderson boys.
Slip that out of your back pocket.
Any words of wisdom before we go, or what?
Yeah, have another beer.
All right, Jack, anything? Is to stop, we stop that.
Well, I'm smoking everything. We're in Herkimer, New York. First leg of the road trip.
Okay.
Things are going well so far.
All right.
I think we're all enjoying ourselves.
Here's Bob getting into the car after gassing up on the trip. Here's a lovely picture of our luxury hotel that we stayed at. Beautiful days in. Here's a picture of us behind the hotel, getting ready to head off to lunch at the Celtic Hop, which you can see this beautiful sign right here. Now we got a picture of our lovely waitress. Bob was excited, so his hand shook when he took the picture. That's why she's blurred. And there's the FX Matt Brewery, otherwise known as the Utica Club Ale. There's the hop from the outside with a picture of Bob standing in front of it. And inside the brewery, here's our 5-gallon mug that we were talking about. There's Dooley and Schultzy, who this trip is named after. There's lovely my brother Chink holding up a Utica Club sign. Here's my brother-in-law, Doug, in the gift shop taking a shot. Here's my brother being real careful with the Saranac plate. And here's a picture of the mash tun from inside the brewery. Some kegs that we saw. Wouldn't you love to have a couple of these for a party over the weekend? Here's the host of the trip and yours truly. There's a picture of Keith with Schultz and Dooley. Don't they look like triplets, huh? And there's a nice basketball game between all the bottles of beer. And at the end of the day, a lovely haul to make off with.
Day two of the road trip. As you can see, we're all still alive. Bob's holding the camera. I'm getting ready.
Can you give us a little synopsis of what happened last night?
Sure. Last night was a blur, but we do remember of it. After we had lunch at the Celtic, which you saw the picture of in the movie, we headed to the game. Went to Babes for dinner. Headed to the game. Good game. Comets won 2-1 in overtime.
Who scored?
Shootout. They tied the game with 7 seconds left, and they won in the sixth round. Went on Irish night, no less. A fella named O'Reilly scored the winning goal for the Comets to put them up 2-1. Good good game. Then we went back to the Irish place, Irish shop, where we had lunch and proceeded to listen to.
So now what can we expect about our day two trip to Syracuse?
All right, so at least this is the plan. And as we all know, plans do go awry. But the plan is to probably grab some breakfast, head up to Syracuse, about an hour away, stop at the Middle Ages Brewery, take the tour of that place. It's usually pretty good. Hit the dinosaur barbecue after that for some grub. And then catch the Crunch Rochester game tonight. And hopefully we see a good game. Have as good a time as we did last night.
Thank you, Jack.
It's like a close one for the
fire.
Where's the picture?
Speak.
Oh, yeah, this is in front of the Middle Ages Brewery. That was a lovely day. And so is this one. This is the same picture about three, maybe 4.5 seconds later. I'm not really sure, but it's still the Middle Ages, as you can tell by the sign. No problem. Proof that Bob was in attendance. This ought to be interesting. Not quite sure what this is about. Ah, there he is, yes. Road trip, 2014. I wonder what they pay for that type of roll-up door there. There's the hardware. Yeah, this is what you need to wear before you go in drinking with us after one of the hockey games. Come in, relax, take your top off. Now, what could be more inviting than that? I mean, Bob has this at his front door, his back door. Well, speaking of his back door. I think this is one of the Stooges' castles that they ran through. Here's some product here, right here. This is a fine growler gift for Christmas. Think about it. Yes. The Christian church is alive and well in Syracuse.
Oh, wait a minute, I got one right here.
Well, there's Mr. Chulo at the Middle Ages Brewery having a little taste test in the tasting room. And there's the dinosaur barbecue. Best barbecue ribs I've ever had in my life. The whole purpose we go to Syracuse is just to go to that barbecue place. There's drunk number one with his bib on, beer number 40 of the trip. Nice drunken smile on his face. I probably looked exact same. And there's drunk number two. Speaking of drunken smiles, there's another drunken smile. I think he's just about to dig into the ribs because he got the ribs that night. Oh, I shouldn't have eaten all those ribs. I can't believe I ate and drank everything. Somebody come and take this plate away before I puke. Yeah, there's me. Same thing. No mas. Can't eat another rib. Can't stuff another piece of food in my face. Can't drink another drop. Until about 5 minutes later when we were probably drinking again. Oh, Bob gets photobombed. That must have been Worcester. Guess she didn't want to be in the picture. Nice picture of the coif there, Bobby. What's that? That's the place in Syracuse, right? Yeah, there's a stadium in Syracuse. Walking by on the way back after the game, most likely. There's Syracuse, yeah. There's the banner for the Syracuse Nationals, NBA World Champions, 54-55. There's a nice picture of a sheet of ice. Not sure what else I'm supposed to say about a sheet of ice, but it's all of a sheet of ice.
Here's a picture of my wife Kathy's seven-layer bars. They were delicious. Boy, did they hit the spot. Most of the trip we had it on Friday, and we had some on Saturday. Delicious. Here's a picture of Keith and the injury of the night. We don't know how it happened, but as you can see, it was bleeding pretty hard. The one who caused the injury to Keith. Who would it be? Ah, the wailing wench. This is the one who inflicted the pain upon Keith Anderson. But as you can see, he survived very, 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 very well. The wailing wench. And finally, Schultze, you got nothing to worry about. As you can see, the grime on this car was worse than anything that we could see in the parking lot. But it kind of fit everything into the theme of our trip. So, Schultze, you got nothing to worry about. So here we are on the third day of the trip. It's Sunday, March 7th, 2014. As you can see, this is our itinerary for the day. So far, it's going excellent. We're going to be going to Worcester today, have a lunch at the Bruce City, and then watch a nice hockey game. Day three highlights. We're in Worcester, Mass, for all you Bostonians. Yeah, going to see a great hockey game. Took a little bit of a side trip. Here's Doug playing Pac-Man, one of his favorite games growing up. I guess he was almost a champ. And there he is with his nice Boston shirt on. Here's the general getting ready to go into the Brew City. Yeah, there it is, Brew City. We had a great time in there. There we are at the DCU Center watching a great hockey game. There's the Worcester team, Atlantic Division champs, a couple of the key players on that team, getting ready. Here's our AHL road trip schedule, going from Friday up to Sunday. Here we are, showing you all the different teams. Boy, it was a great weekend. Fantastic. And finally, here's our cast of characters to the AHL road trip. Hopefully next year we can do it again. I'll tell you, it was a blast. Over and out.
On a long and lonesome highway east of Omaha, you can listen to the engine moaning out his one-note song. You can think about the woman or the girl you knew the night before. But your thoughts will soon be wandering the way they always do when you're riding 16 hours and there's nothing much to do.
This was a film produced by Jack Anderson and Bob Chulo. We went up into Upper State New York in February to see three hockey games, AHL games. We went to a few breweries, and Jack and I produced this. We had a great time doing it.